despite this pandemic spread, they are systematically underdiagnosed and untreated, even in developed countries. As you can see, an example here about postpartum depression in a study by the United States. One in five low-income moms is diagnosed with postpartum depression, and from this, only one in ten receive treatment. We are talking about developed countries. So perinatal mental disorders benefit not only from the stigma of society in the context of a universal cultural model of the mother-child relationship, but also from the neglect of the medical staff in some situations. The accessibility of women to specialized medical or psychological services is reduced, both due to the deficiencies in development of the mental health network and due to prejudices of the population. And the consequences are significant, not only for the mother, but also for the child, for the family, and for the society. So, before classification, depression, we can say that depression is when bedtime comes and never leave the house. We have here the classification of perinatal mental disorders from the adjustment disorders and distress to this psychiatric emergency, which is postpartum psychosis. And I underline that postpartum blues and baby blues, as Professor Enantescu said before, are not a part of these perinatal mental disorders. Symptoms. Part of the symptoms are connected with emotional, or another part of the symptoms are connected with somatic, and another part of the symptoms are connected with cognition. Related to morbidity and burden, 50 to 80% of women may experience the baby blues, transient postpartum disorder, and 10 to 20% of women experience postpartum depression. 2 in 10 women have a mental health problem during pregnancy and in the first year following the birth, and only 25% of women get diagnosed and receive an adequate treatment and support. In fact, a meta-analysis published in 2017 identified a prevalence of self-reported antenatal anxiety disorder and depression of 9.5% and those clinically diagnosed of 9.3%. Postnatal self-reported anxiety disorder and depression amounted to 8.2% and the clinical ones at 4.2%. Around the world, the percentages are in some situations comparable. Other situations are different. For example, in the United States, perinatal depression is somewhere between 7% and 20%, and postpartum depression 12%. In Mexico, postnatal depression at 9% and postpartum depression at 13.8%. In Portugal, postnatal depression somewhere between 2.3 and 1.3%, and postpartum depression 11.7. In Italy, postnatal depression 21.9% and postpartum depression 13.2%. In Sweden, 13%, and in Norway, 10% for postpartum depression. In Asia, postnatal depression 20% and postpartum depression 21.8%. And in Australia, postnatal depression 8.9% and postpartum depression 4.7%. Postpartum psychosis related to mortality now. Postpartum psychosis occurs in 1 to 1,000 maternities with a suicide rate of 1.27 per 100,000 in the first 6 postpartum months. And suicide is the second most common cause of mortality in postpartum women. Almost a quarter of postpartum psychosis is one of the leading causes of infanticide with an incidence of 8 per 100,000 births in the United States. Something about fathers. 4.8% of fathers experience depression in the first year after their child's birth. It's between 1% and 26% of new fathers. And younger fathers, those with a history of depression and those experiencing material professional difficulties, were most likely to experience depression. Now, a parallel between months and deaths, up to 1 to 20 deaths, and 1 in 7 months are diagnosed with postnatal depression each year in Australia. Related to burden, there are additional costs for the public health system, and we can see here a situation from the United Kingdom. So the known cost of perinatal mental health problems per year versus in the United Kingdom are around 8 billion sterling pounds each year. And 28% of this cost are related to the mother and 72% are related to the child. The most important aspects related to risk factors. These risk factors are classified into 5 classes. The first class or category are physical and biological. Some of them, like the young mother stage, family personal psychiatric history, the existence of chronic pathology, having a female partner for death. Having a female partner who has postpartum depression is one of the strongest predictors of maternal postpartum depression.
was healing in Central Eastern Europe, with that kind of tradition to be with the family and family member, including fathers, is somehow a cultural issue. Of course, when we are speaking about the United States, different cultures and complexity, but